All right, we're in Kill Devil Hills right now, giving you a tour, passing the Jolly Rogers restaurant, right around mile marker 4, I believe, is where we are right now. The Days Inn is right here. This is where a lot of the hotels start. So there's the Days Inn, which actually splits both sides of the road. The Sea Ranch, which is a really big place, and they've got a lot of ocean front. And then there's this section of really nice houses. It's called the Wellington by the Sea. The Sands Condominiums. This is where a lot of the commercialization kind of starts, on the beach side in Kill Devil Hills. Goomba's Grill. I don't know anything about that. No one's talked to me about that. The Crystal Shores Condominiums are right there. The Golden Strand, which is an older one. I've heard people talk about that. It's been around for a while. And a couple of just monster houses to the left, on right on the water. I'm talking like 6,000 square feet homes. They're huge. There's definitely some people with some money that have done some things around here. The Croatan Surf Club is right here. So, the purpose of these videos are just to try to give you kind of some bearings, maybe some landmarks. I always try to mention where there is something to write down before your trip up here. I mean, they do a great job over here with the visitor centers, with available information and maps. But the purpose of these videos are just to kind of give you an idea of where everything is if you're going to come down here and what it looks like. Here's where the Wright Brothers Memorial is. To our right, we're going to have a tour of that on our YouTube channel and on our website as well. It's amazing. It's where where it all started is right here. So the Travelodge, the Nags Head Beach Hotel is also what it's called, is right here as well. It's literally across the street from the Wright Brothers Memorial. And been around. Travelodge has obviously been here for a really long time. And then the Quality Inn is over here. Like I said, this is where a lot of the hotels are. So if you have a hotel booked at Kill Devil Hills, these are the mile markers you're going to want to be around down here on this road, in the 2s and the 3s and the 4s. Here's the Days Inn to the left. The Best Western is to the left. These are really popular. If you look on websites like TripAdvisor, they'll talk a lot about this Best Western, that Days Inn. It's a little convenient stop. The Exxon. This bicycle place to the left, the Outer Banks Bicycle, is real popular for people renting bicycles. Little trading post, kind of like an older Wings. This place to the right here, Porta Canal Restaurant. I've been told it's pretty good for bringing kids, and got a lot to look at and a lot of things to do there while the kids are eating. I have not eaten there though, so I'm not going to give you my critique on that. Couple little hotels, couple churches are all right in here. Got some people crossing the road. Can't wait to get over to the beach, have some fun, put some sand between their toes. So this section of the beach, we're in Kill Devil Hills, just a lot of condominiums, a lot of rental homes. I mean, it's pretty easy to figure out when you get down here. These little circle things to the right are a trip. They look like big, huge mushrooms. I don't even know what that place is called, but I've heard people talk about the mushrooms. Big cylinders. And just so you know, this is kind of like what I call old school Outer Banks. This is where some locals live. I always try to protect the locals as much as I can. They live here year-round and put up with a lot of traffic and a lot of tourism and a lot of people. certain times of the year, so definitely respect them when you come here. They love you being here, but they don't cry when people leave either. Alright, so this is kind of going to be the end of what I call our B-side tour, because this is where the Ramada Inn is. So you have the Comfort Inn, and you have the Ramada Inn, and they're the two other large hotels right on this side here. I've stayed at the Ramada Inn. It's a little overpriced, but it is convenient. And the Comfort Inn I have not stayed at, but you can definitely tell. You know, they're placed in convenience. When you go one block over to the main road, 158 there, it's there's a lot to do there. To our right here is the Kill Devil Grill. See that oval sign to the right? That's kind of the end of what I call this area. It's a good place. It's small. But you can definitely check out the Kill Devil Grill if you just want a sandwich or salad.